Welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to be looking at some miscellaneous definitions. So, starting with page swapping, the first thing to note here that when RAM is divided into chunks of memory which are stored into hard disk so that they can later be retrieved back into the RAM and this implements virtual memory, then such a chunk of RAM is called a page, and hence page swapping or disk swapping refers to a process where a page is removed from the main memory and copied to the hard drive from which it can be accessed for future use. It is necessary when the system requires more memory than it has physically available in its RAM, and it is also useful since some number of pages are used by applications only to initialize and hence are nearly never required later. So swapping helps in this case, but excessive swapping can lead to slowdown of computer. Next we have the DMA or direct memory access, and it is a feature of computer system that allow hardware subsystems to access main memory independently of the CPU, and this reduces the CPU overhead. We have codecs, which are short for compressor decompressor, and they are computer programs capable of encoding or decoding a digital data stream or signal. For each audio or video file format, we have a specific codec for them also. Next comes hyperthreading. Intel's HD technology intelligently schedules her work so that CPU is always doing some work and no time is wasted, since the next job is ready to be executed before the first job is completed. However, it is not same as doubling the speed, it only reduces the wasted time. Moreover, it increases power consumption and causes the CPU to heat up. But we also have multithreading, in which the CPU actually does many jobs side by side. There is also the CMOS or complementary metal oxide semiconductor, and it typically refers to a battery operated memory chip in our computer that stores startup information. Our computer's basic input output system or BIOS uses this information when starting your computer. Display adapters provide a link between CPU and monitor and convert binary forms of information into human readable forms. Jumpers are small metal conductors which act like an on-off switch and are typically made from a small piece of metal and two wires. They are found on motherboard, printed circuits, modern hard disk controllers, etc. Now we come to the killer app. It is an application that becomes so necessary or desirable that consumers would buy the hardware to run the software. And here on screen we have an example of killer app, that is Lotus 123 Spreadsheets. Moving on to RAID or redundant array of inexpensive disks is a data storage virtualization technique that combines multiple physical disk drives into a single logical unit for the purposes of data redundancy, performance improvement, or both. Now we come on to the waterfall method of software development, in which the steps can be generally categorized as requirement analysis, design implementation, testing, deployment, and maintenance. But they are often further shortened to just 5 steps, which are requirement, design, implementation, verification, and maintenance. As opposed to this model, we also have RAD or Rapid Application Development model, and it is used to refer to alternatives to conventional waterfall model of software development. Coming on to DDK, it is an acronym for Driver Development Kit and is same as SDK or Standard Development Kit. Now we come on to thrashing. It occurs when a computer's memory is in a constant stage of paging. This causes the performance of the computer to degrade or collapse greatly. This situation may continue indefinitely until the underlying cause is addressed. Thrashing is a state in which the CPU performs productive work less and swapping more. It is caused by lack of RAM or when too many programs are being run, or when the programs that may have issues with memory usage and memory leakage are being run. When tape record memory computers went in this state, the sound came of thrashing and hence the name. There is also a term ripping, which is the process of copying audio or video content to a hard disk, typically from a removable media such as a CD or DVD, although the word refers to all forms of media. Ripping is distinct from simple file copying in that the source audio or video often isn't originally formatted for ease of use in a computer file system, and ripping such data usually involves reformatting it and optionally compressing it during the extraction process. Now let us discuss the layers of the CD. At A, we have the polycarbonate disk layer which encodes data on the bumps. B is the shiny layer which reflects the laser. C is a layer of lacquer which protects the shiny layer. And D is the artwork which is screen printed on the top. Analog buffers amplify any analog signal from one circuit to another. And potentiometers informally a pot, is a three-terminal resistor with a sliding or rotating contact that forms an adjustable voltage divider. If only two terminals are used, one end and one and the other wiper, it acts as a variable resistor or rheostat. Moving on to CPRM or CPPM, which stands for Content Protection for Recordable Media or for Content Protection for Pre-Record Media, and they are a mechanism for controlling copying, moving and deletion of digital media, most popularly on SD cards, and was developed by the 4C Entity LLC. And this 4C Entity comprises of Intel, IBM, Toshiba and Maxo Zisha. Finally, we have the NVMe Express, NVMe, or Non-Volatile Memory Host Controller Interface, or NVMe HCI, which is a specification used for accessing SD cards through PCI bus in computers. At last, we end with the software Cygwin, which provides a Unix-like environment and a command line interface for Windows.